come through the media portal for the rest of the day. Thank you.
Good morning, and thank you for being here. We'd like to update you on the progress of the criminal investigation. First, I realize that no action we take can replace the loss suffered here. I'm deeply sorry for what occurred. I've received so many contacts from our officers. We want to express how sorry they are as well, and how this is not indicative of the work they do every day. Human life is a precious thing and should not have been taken from Ms. Jefferson. This incident has eroded the trust that we have built with our community, and we must now work even harder to ensure that trust is restored. Concerning the status of the criminal investigation, at approximately 6 p.m. yesterday, Aaron Dean was arrested for the murder of Ms. Jefferson. We obtained an arrest warrant after enough evidence and facts were analyzed and verified. A team of officers quickly effected his arrest at the office of his attorney. He was booked into the Tarrant County Jail, where his bond was set by the presiding magistrate. He has since posted bond. We're continuing to work closely with the Tarrant County Criminal District Attorney's Office to ensure this entire investigation is prosecuted in a thorough, meticulous, and solid manner. To the citizens and the residents of our city, we understand your frustration and disappointment. I too am frustrated and disappointed by what occurred and the officer's actions. We never want an officer's response to a call to end in the loss of life. We have a great many officers who work extremely hard every day, and they do this at great sacrifice and with a servant's heart. I ask you to please do not let the actions of one officer reflect on the other 1,700. There's absolutely no excuse for this incident, and the person responsible will be held accountable. Ms. Jefferson's family and our community will have the last word, and the courts will speak on her behalf. Each and every one of you have our support and our commitment to serve you better. We strive to be better every day than we were the day before. My prayer for Atatiana's family, our community, and our department comes from Numbers chapter 6, verses 24 and 26. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. We'll take some questions.
Chief, the Jefferson family says that they want reform from what they see as a brutal police culture. Chief, what needs to change for the Fort Worth police?
As the city manager alluded to yesterday, we're looking at bringing in an independent third party group to come in and evaluate our policies, our practices, and our training to ensure that we are above best practice standards.
There was the gun released, an image of a gun released. Do we know anything about the gun or the officer felt threatened by the gun that belonged to Ms. Jefferson?
I cannot tell you what he felt. He did not give a statement to our investigators. The gun was found just inside the room, but it makes sense that she would have a gun if she felt that she was being threatened or there was someone in the backyard.
Chief, officers from what department exactly arrested Mr. Deanne? Was there any kind of incident in that?
They were Fort Worth officers, and I was not made aware that there was any type of struggle or anything like that.
Light shed on why, if they were responding to a welfare check, why did they park around the corner from the house, and also why did they not ring the doorbell or knock on the door?
Yes, so they believe they were responding to an open structure call and not just a welfare check.
Chief, my question to that, because you said that yesterday, who determined, this neighbor called and said the door's open, obviously, who determined, okay, this is an open structure call versus a welfare check? Because as you said yesterday, those are two different types of responses by the officer. Who determined that?
So the information came from the neighbor to the call takers, and then while it was relayed to the dispatch, it it was determined to be an open structure call.
So the dispatcher?
I don't know if it, I can't tell you specifically if it was a dispatcher, but that's something we're looking into.
Well, Chief, we heard the call from the neighbor and then from dispatch to police
Correct.
Officers, and it was a signal 56, I think it is. What is procedure for officers on an open structure? Is it to go onto the property and look in windows? It's an open structure. Do you think common sense would be to knock on a door?
Well, it depends on what the officers believe at the time. If they think the structure is open due to somebody breaking in or something like that, that would elicit one response. If they think it's just somebody left their door open, that would elicit a separate response.
Chief, in your memory, is this the fastest an officer has been prosecuted?
He has not been prosecuted yet. He has simply been arrested. There's still a long haul ahead of us. To my knowledge, yes.
What kind of toll has this taken on morale throughout the department? You've got officers who are still having to be out and responding to calls, and this has to take a toll. And what steps, actual steps, have been taken to deal with that?
So the morale piece is, I don't have any officers saying this action should not have been taken against this individual, this officer. I'm getting the complete opposite response. Chief, thank you for being quick and decisive. This is going to help heal us. The officers are hurting. I've been out there on patrol and since this occurred, and it's the officer, they come up and hug, and it's very emotional because the officers, they try hard every day to try to make this city better. I likened it yesterday to some of our officers that are out there every weekend and most weeknights that they're out there trying to build these relationships. And I likened it to a bunch of ants building an ant hill, and then somebody comes with a hose and washes it away, and they just have to start from scratch and build over. I think that's going to be all. Thank you.
Also, in addition, we're going to be posting the arrest warrant to the media portal. So here in about 30 minutes, it'll be available on the media portal to you. No more questions as far today. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you.